are very welcome back. Now, earlier this morning, we met the lovely 55-year-old Paula Caulfield, who felt that it was time to give her look a little bit of a revamp. And our glam squad have been working tirelessly behind the scenes, and it's time to get an update on how they are getting on. Good morning, to you all. Hello. You had a lovely canvas.
Yes.
And Paula, we didn't actually share your age earlier, but if I was 55 and I looked like you,
oh my God,
I'd put that age out there.
Yes.
Oh, thank you so much.
Let's first of all just ask you, what is your makeup and hair routine normally?
Normally, I wouldn't wear a lot of makeup, especially eye makeup. I can't really put it on that well.
Would you like to be able to do it?
Yeah, I would actually. And Derrick was showing me how to, you know, make the eyes look bigger because I've quite small eyes. Yeah, so I would probably just a little bit of foundation, maybe.
That's what you would normally
put on. Maybe just a bit of powder every
morning.
And
then if you were, you know, hitting the tiles night out, would you try and put on a little bit more?
Yeah, I try and venture out a little bit more. It doesn't always work out. But I do try a little bit.
And what about your hair? Because I was complimenting your lovely highlights earlier, and you still have lovely long hair. What would you normally do with it on a day-to-day basis?
Normally, I would just leave it straight.
Yes.
But if I was going out sometimes, I'd like a nice, soft wave.
And are you good at doing that yourself?
Sometimes.
Yeah, like myself. It's hit or miss. It's hit or miss.
Sometimes it works.
Depends on the day.
Yeah. So, look, Derrick, we have a gorgeous face to work on.
Gorgeous face to work on.
What have you done so far?
Well, so far, we've done Lasting Radiance Foundation from Rimmel with a little bit of concealer and powder from Maybelline just to set and to even out the skin tone. It's got a yellow base, so it's counteracting any redness. We've also used this fabulous product from Max Factor. It's a brow contouring kit to define our brows.
Yes, I'm not going to lie, they were the first thing I noticed.
Which frames the face.
Which you always say that.
Yes, yeah. It's very important. Even if you're doing a minimal amount of makeup on the eyes or the lips or whatever, a little bit of brow definition can really give a lift to the face. It's like an instant facelift without the doctor.
Oh,
yeah.
Hello, let's have a bit more of that. And would you have done that before? Would you have always filled in your eyebrows or gone and got them dyed or waxed or threaded?
Yeah, sometimes I would get them, say every few weeks I would get them threaded and I'd get a slight tint.
A tint, yeah. Because when you're blonde sometimes.
Yeah, when you're blonde, they do kind of, you know, they give definition when you get that little bit of a tint.
But I have to say, they're really well done. If we look in the camera there, they really suit you actually. And with what did you do?
Just using the product here, the brow contour kit, if I use a flat brush and do like a line from the bottom, just straight, and a parallel line on the top, and you're just kind of filling it in.
So you do the two lines first?
Two lines and then you fill in, exactly.
Okay,
two parallel lines. What people make a mistake when they're doing brows is start going for a curve straight away.
Yes.
So you want to keep it parallel, straight lines, and then curve it round slightly to the brow then as well.
How do you ensure that you don't end up, what's it called, the Liverpool brow, wasn't it?
The slug brows, is it?
Yeah, that's too heavy. Yeah.
I think it's probably being careful. If you're going with giving it the right shape, like I'm saying, looking at it as two parallel lines and then taking the brow around, rather than going for a curve straight away, and then the colour not too intense. Never go for black on the brows. Never do black. Even if you want dark brows, don't do black because it's going to look... That's that brow you're talking about.
And we also have some eye makeup here, and I love the colours, and I love the little bit of shimmer under the eye.
This is a magnified spice edition from Rimmel, and they come in nude, they come in this colour, they come in many different colours. You can see the array of colours you have. It's absolutely amazing. I've gone for the more rustic, goldy colours, just blended around the eyes. And what Paula mentioned was that she finds when she's doing eye makeup, she keeps the shadow right to the lash line, and she feels it makes her eyes look very small.
Yes.
So when you put the shadow around the eyes, blend it slightly down so it's not tight to the lash line, so you're making the eyes appear bigger. Okay. So giving a slight blend more down from the eye.
I need to write my notebook. Yeah. what have you done? Because she had lovely and has lovely long hair.
She does.
Do I see some? You do see.
So I have been busy doing my Hairtalk extensions this morning. So basically, Paula's hair is long, but you know, like any long hair, it kind of fades out towards the end. Like, she has a lot of hair, but it's very fine. So we just wanted to kind of bulk up her ends a little bit and just thicken it out a little bit more. And also, she was saying to me, I said, well, you know, because she was so easygoing and, you know, she didn't want to go dark and she didn't want to cut her hair too much. And I said, well, you know, what would you like for your hair? And she said, I'd love to be able to do those boho waves.
Yes.
So I find that these boho waves, like, you kind of need to have extensions or something in it for it to last,
yeah,
I think.
When you see celebrities who have that hair and you wonder, what have they got
exactly
that I don't have?
So I have done these Hair Talk tape-in extensions, Ciara. We were talking about them for a minute beforehand. They are amazing. They last for 6 to 8 weeks.
Did you do it the whole way around?
I've done it the whole way around her head, yeah.
Okay.
The whole way around.
And then you're able to curl the hair.
So you're able to curl the hair. But, like, they're so comfortable. They sit so flat. And you can put the hair sleek back or you can leave it down. And they last 6 to 8 weeks. And once you have them in, you can apply the same hair up to 3 times.
Okay. Lovely. So then, so we'll come back to this later because we just wanted to give people just a quick look at some of the work that's going on. And we'll have the full reveal a little later in the programme, but still to come on Ireland AM, see how our reporter Brianna got on when she sat down with the Hollywood star that is Saoirse Ronan to hear about her role in Little Women. And we'll also be putting more of your important questions to the big man himself, to Santa.